Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we were doing area of a rectangle and square. How to find area of rectangle and square using formula. Now, what is the formula for finding area of a rectangle? That is length multiplied by breadth. And area of a square, that is side multiplied by side. So children, in that row from exercise 13.3, we were taking example in the last class. Today I will continue with the examples, and after understanding the example we are going to shift to the questions from the exercise 13.3. So today children, we are going to do exercise 13.3 examples. So let's start children. Today we will do examples of exercise 13.3. So in that row children, we have already done example 3 and 4. So today I will start with example 5. Example 5. Now what is given in example 5? The length and the breadth of a rectangle are 7 meter, 50 centimeter and 60 centimeter respectively. Find its area. So now what is given here? Length of a rectangular park. Length of a rectangular park. Now what is that? What is the length? That is 7 meter 50 centimeter. 7 meter 50 centimeter. Now here breadth is given in centimeter. So you are supposed to change this length in centimeter. We all are aware that 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. So 700 plus 50, and the total will be 750 centimeter. We know 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. So here that 7 will be multiplied by 100. So the total will be 700 plus 50, and length of that rectangular park will become 750 centimeter. Now children, what else is given here? Breadth of a rectangular park. Breadth of a rectangular park, that is 60 centimeter. Now this is also given in centimeter, and this is also given in 60 centimeter. Now what you are supposed to find it out here? Area of a rectangular park. Or simply you can write area of a park. That will be equal to length multiplied by breadth. So now what we will do? We'll put these values in this question. That is length multiplied by breadth. That will become 750 centimeter will be multiplied by 60 centimeter. So what we have seen in this question? In this question we have seen how to find area of a rectangle whose length is given. Important part of this question is that the unit which is given. Unit is the important part. That unit will be same in both length and breadth. So here what we will do, 6 will be multiplied by this. 6 5s are 30, 3 6 7s are 42, 43, 44, 45, and 2 more zeros, and answer you will be getting in centimeter square. Now this can be changed into meter square? Yes, because in 1 meter square, this conversion we have already done. 1 meter is equals to 10,000 centimeter square. It means this is going to divide it by 10,000. We'll divide it, and this 4.5 will become meter square. Now here in this question we will be having two important part. First part is this, that is your conversion part, that you have to you will be having length and breadth in same unit, and after finding if you are getting area in bigger number, like if you are using centimeter, obviously you will be getting number which is a little bit bigger. So what you will do it in that case, in that case you are going to convert it into meter square. So that is one of the thing of this example 5. So children, these examples are also very important. These examples you are going to do it in your copy yourself, and if you will understand that example, fine. If you will having any doubt, that we will take it in class. So now with this we'll finish this example 5. Two parts are very important, and later on this conversion part which we have done, very few questions were given related to that conversion, but we'll keep on doing practice. So children, let's start with example 6, that is perimeter. Example 6 is what? The perimeter of a rectangle is 14 meter and its length is 4 meter. Find its area. So for finding area, I'll read out the question once again. The perimeter of a rectangle is 14 meter and its length is 4 meter. Now find its area. The perimeter of a rectangle is 14 meter and its length is 4 meter. Find its area. So for finding area of a rectangular figure or a rectangle, you required breadth also. So how you are going to find it out? Now perimeter of a rectangle is given, length is given, you are going to find it out breadth of that rectangle. So we'll write first perimeter of a rectangle. What is the perimeter? Perimeter is 14 meter. Perimeter is 14 meter. This is given to you. 14 meter perimeter is equals to 14 meter. Length of rectangle. Length of a rectangle is given. Length of a rectangle, that is equals to, that is what? 4 meter. So we are going to use these two things in the formula of perimeter to find the breadth. So we'll write this perimeter is equals to a perimeter of a rectangle is equals to what? Is equals to 2 will be multiplied by length plus breadth. So what we will do now? We'll put the value 14 meter. Here 2 will be multiplied by 4 meter plus breadth. So what we will do? Next 14 meter, 2 fours are will be 8. Or this 2 we can do division on this side. So we'll divide it here. And what is left? 4 meter plus breadth. So now you can find it out. What is the breadth? 2 sevens are 14, 7 meter. And which implies breadth is equals to 7 minus 4. That will become 3 meter. This is your breadth of a rectangle. Now what else is left? First we'll understand this. See children, in this I'm using the formula of perimeter to find breadth of a rectangle. Length and perimeter is already given. You are supposed to find it out breadth of that particular figure. Fine. So what we are doing it, perimeter of a rectangle, this formula we all are aware of it, that is 2 multiplied by length plus breadth. So in that formula we are going to put here 14 meter is equals to 2 will be multiplied by 4 meter plus breadth. So we'll write it 4 meter plus breadth, and that will be cancelled. 2 7s will be 47 meter. So from 7 meter we'll subtract 4 meter, and here we will get breadth, that is 3 meter. So children, after this what you are supposed to find it out? Area of a rectangle. So that only will be left, area of a rectangle. So what is the formula? Area of a rectangle, the formula is length multiplied by breadth. So length is 4 meter, this will be 3 meter, 4 threes are will be 12 meter square. So this will become your area of a rectangle. So children, what you have seen in this question, you have understood that you can find area of a particular rectangle if you have been given with perimeter and length, or perimeter and breadth. See, in this question you have been given with perimeter and length, and then you can find breadth of that particular rectangle, and then you can find area. So instead of breadth, if you have to find length, similar question is there from the exercise also, in your exercise also. So you can find it out there. See children, this we can do it in both the questions. Like if you have been given with the perimeter of a rectangle and length, or perimeter and breadth, in that case we can find it out area of that particular rectangle. Second is what, when you have been given with perimeter of a square, then also we can find it out area of that particular square. How? That we will see in example number 7. So children, let's start that example number 7. Now in example number 7, again you have been given with perimeter of a square. Perimeter of a square. A square carom board number 7. The seventh example, a square carom board has a perimeter of 320 meter. Now perimeter of a square carom board is given. Perimeter of a square carom board. So what is the perimeter here? The perimeter is already given, that is your 320 centimeter. So now perimeter of a square carom board, that is 320 centimeter. Now side of a square carom board. What is the side of the square carom board? What we will do, this 320 will be divided by 4. So instead of writing this directly here, we are going to write here perimeter divided by 4. The formula which we have already done in the previous exercise. Perimeter divided by 4. So now what we will do? We will do the division here. 320 centimeter will be divided by 4. So 4 8s are 32, 80 centimeter. Now this 80 centimeter will become side of a square carom board. Now side of a square carom board will become 80 centimeter. This 80 centimeter. Now what you are going to do it? Now we will find it out area of a square carom board. Formula, we all are aware of it. Area of a square carom board. Formula is what? Formula is side multiplied by That means 80 centimeter will be multiplied by 80 centimeter. 8 8s will be
64.
6400 centimeter square.
Centimeter square or square centimeter. Fine. Any one thing you can write. So that is your example number 7. What we have seen in this example, first perimeter of a square is given. First we will find it out what will be the side of a square carom board, that is perimeter divided by 4, and then 320 centimeter will be divided by 4. Here the perimeter will become 80 centimeter. Now area of a square carom board is equal to side multiplied by side. 80 centimeter will be multiplied by 80 centimeter. So what we have got? We have got the area of a square carom board, that is side multiplied by side. From this step, with 80 centimeter we have got side of a square carom board, because you have been given with perimeter of that square carom board. So formula we have already done in the previous exercise, children. Now children, we'll start with next example 8. Children, these examples are very important. You all will do practice of these examples, and if you are having any doubt, that doubt will be taken in the class. Again and again I am saying this, that the doubt will be taken in the class, because many of you are fine. Now example number 8. Example 8. Arun plans to tile his kitchen floor with square tiles. Now each side of a square tile is 10 centimeter. His kitchen is 320 centimeter long and 200 centimeter wide. How many tiles will be needed? Now what is given? Length of the kitchen is given. Length of the kitchen. What is given to you? Length of the kitchen. Length of the kitchen will be given to you. What is the length of the kitchen? Length of the kitchen is 320 centimeter. That is 320 centimeter. Now what next? Breadth of the kitchen. Breadth of the kitchen. Breadth of the kitchen is what? That is, breadth of the kitchen is 200 centimeter. 200 centimeter. Now first of all, you are supposed to find it out, area of the kitchen. Area of the kitchen. So what is the formula for finding area of the kitchen? What you have been given? You have been given with length and breadth of a kitchen. Now you are supposed to find it out, area of the kitchen. Now what is the area of the kitchen? What is the formula here? The formula is length multiplied by breadth. Length multiplied by breadth. So we'll do it, 320 centimeter multiplied by 200 centimeter. Now area is 6430 centimeter square. This is your area of the kitchen. Now what you are supposed to find it out? Area of one tile. Area of one tile. Now tile is in square shape. What is the shape of the tile? The tile is in square shape. Means, for finding this area, we required this formula, side multiplied by side. So that will become 10 centimeter will be multiplied by 10 centimeter, that will become 100 centimeter square. Now, whenever you have to find it out, number of tiles or number of bricks or number of whatever that will be put on a floor, on a wall or whatever. So area of that particular floor, area of that particular wall, and after that, that will be divided by side or area occupied by a tile. Fine. So here we will find it out. Therefore, number of tiles required. Number of tiles required. How many number of tiles required? That will be 64,000 divided by 100. Cancel two zeros, and here see this centimeter square will also be cancelled because in both we will be having centimeter square. See, area of that kitchen is 64,000 centimeter square and area of a tile is 100 centimeter square. So we are going to cancel this centimeter square also, and you will be left with 640 tiles. See children, remember this in all the question. Whenever you have been given with a question in which you will be given with length or breadth, or if you have been given with perimeter and then you are supposed to find it out area, whenever this kind of a question that floor is plans to pave that floor with the square tiles and or put the square tiles, and how much tiles will be needed. So what you will do, what area in which tiles has to put in, and that area will be divided by the area of one tile, and after doing division you will be getting that number of tiles required. So here you can see what is the first statement, length of the kitchen, that is 320 centimeter. Then breadth of the kitchen, that is 200 centimeter. Area of the kitchen, that will be equal to length multiplied by breadth. It means 320 centimeter will be multiplied by 200 centimeter. Do the multiplication here. After doing the multiplication, then you will be able to find it out area of the kitchen. Now here we have find it out area of the kitchen. That means 320 centimeter will be multiplied by 200 centimeter, and we have got 64,000 centimeter square. Now area of one tile. One tile, what is the area of one tile? That is 10 centimeter multiplied by 10 centimeter is equals to 100 centimeter square. Now number of tiles required. Whenever you will be having this kind of equation, you will find it out two areas. One area is of particular brick or tile. Second area is of the area or the place where you have to put in. So after that, area of the floor, that will be divided by area occupied by one tile. So here we have got number of tiles required is equals to 64,000 centimeter square will be divided by 100 centimeter square, and the answer is 640 tiles. So children, with this we have finished with example 8 and we'll move to example 9 now. Urvashi made a rectangular design which is 8 centimeter wide. Okay, fine. Now I'll read out the question and then I'll Urvashi made example 9. This is your last example of this exercise 13.3, and then you have been left with only one question of exercise, that we will see. Now example 9, Urvashi made a rectangular design which is 8 centimeter wide. Example 9. Now what is given to you, that what is the width of that design, that is given. Length is not given. So you are supposed to find it out. Now what is there? Area of a rectangular design, that is given. Area of a rectangular design. What is the area of a rectangular design that is 80 square centimeter? 80 square centimeter. Now what else is given? You have been given breadth of a design. Breadth is also given. Now children, I am going to tell you one formula which you can use when you have been given with length or breadth. Now breadth of a design, that is 8 centimeter. 8 centimeter. Now you are supposed to find it out length of a design. Now what is the length of a design? That is area divided by breadth. See children, this formula you can use in two ways. If here length you have to find it out, then area will be divided by breadth. And if you have to find it out breadth here, then area will be divided by length. So now what we will do? We'll do the division. This 80 centimeter will be divided by 8 and that will become 10 centimeter. That will become 8 tens are 80. And length of the design will become 10 centimeter. So children, what we have seen in this example, that you have been given with area of a rectangular design, that is 80 centimeter square or 80 square centimeter. Breadth is 8 centimeter. You are supposed to find it out length of that particular design. See children, whenever length you have to find it out, that area will be divided by breadth, and when breadth will be find it out and you have to find it out breadth, then area will be divided by length. So do the division. 80 centimeter will be divided by 8 and you will be getting 10 centimeter. 10 centimeter, 8 tens are 80, so that will become 10 centimeter. So that will become length of that particular design. Now children, we will be left with only one question, that is your last 10th question of exercise 13.3. I'll explain it and you are supposed to do it your own. Now question number 10 is, a room is 680 centimeter long and 320 centimeter wide. It is to be paved with square marble tiles of side 40 centimeter. Again, length is given, breadth is given. You are supposed to find it out area of that room. Area of that room. After finding its area, you have to find area of that square tiles. Now, after finding both the areas, that is same as of example 8 which we have seen just now. After finding area of a square tile, what you will do? That will be divided by this one. And you will be getting the answer. So I hope that question number 10, that is area of a room, you have to find it out. After finding that area of a room, then you are going to do it. That what will be the square marble tiles, area of what will be the area of a square marble tile, that you have to find it out. Then area of a room, to find a number of tiles required, you have to divide area of the square tiles, that will be divided by square tiles, area of the room will be divided by area of the square tile. And you will be getting number of tiles required to pave the room. So that question number 10, you all will do it from the exercise 13.3. From exercise 13.3, question number 10, that will be your homework. And you are going to do that question number 10 yourself. So here I am going to finish the class. And I hope examples which we have done today, that will be clear to you all. you all will do practice of these examples in your notebook. So children, that's all for today. Have a good day.